Welcome back. Tonight we're going to take a look at the 1962 Hugo award-winning novel in Robert Heinlein's Stranger in a Strange Land. So I'm going to do my normal thing, provide a bit of a plot overview, tell you what I liked, what I didn't like. I'll put these books to the memory test and we'll then rank it on our Sci-Fi Shed ladder that we've got going on here, which aims to rank all the Hugo and Nebula award-winning novels. Now, this book probably needs little introduction. It's probably one of Robert Heinlein's most famous books. That with Starship Troopers, I would say, are the two most popular of his novels. And it's also, I would dare say, his most controversial novel, because Robert really did set out to write a book that challenges all the axioms of Western culture, right? So it's a very controversial book, and its actual working title was known as The Hectic, or The Heretic, rather. It's also a bit hectic. The Heretic. Because, again, it was just trying to break all those social norms and really challenge your thinking in these things. So the story follows this guy called Michael Smith. And he's the sole survivor of this shuttle that landed on Mars. And it's believed that everyone actually perished in that crash. But what we learn is that there's a second shuttle that eventually goes back to Mars. And they find that there was a survivor in Michael Smith. And they bring him back to Earth. And what we find is that Michael Smith, he's extraordinarily intelligent. He's got supernatural abilities where he can levitate objects and make things disappear. And he can also change his body, right? So he can actually decide that he wants to be stronger, fitter, or whatever the case may be. And he can also, you know, bring his heart rate down to a point where he almost looks like he's died. So he's got some very supernatural abilities. But he's also trying to come to grip with what it means to be human. So he's going through a journey of discovery and learning of what it is to be human, what it is to be oneself, right? And what we find is that there's a nurse on the ward in the hospital that he's been taken to, because he's sort of getting used to the gravity of Earth. And she inadvertently partakes in a water-sharing ceremony. So she had a glass of water with Mike. And Mike being a Martian, water being rare on Mars, it's seen as a very sacred rite, and a bond is formed when you have this water-sharing ceremonies that is stronger than marriage, really. So she inadvertently falls into this relationship with Mike as a water brother. And she then introduces him to her boyfriend and also this guy called Jubal. And Jubal is this famous writer. He's a wealthy kind of person. He's a typical Robert Heinlein character, if you've read any of his past books, and some of which we've read on the Sci-Fi Shed ladder here, like Starship Troopers, the sergeants that were there during those break camps, as well as what we found in The Moon is a Harsh Mistress. So is that typical, almost Robert Heinlein character in the book itself. And he's a very sort of interesting person, and he tries to understand Mike's point of view and tries to nurture and mentor him into becoming the person that he needs to be. And the plot is sort of, I'll leave it like that as the plot. You've got this guy called Michael Smith, superhuman natural abilities, trying to understand what it means to become human, who then goes about and brings these people into in a water-sharing sort of union with him, and who ultimately goes on to start a religion. And he becomes this messianic figure as well, and a whole lot of stuff happens, and we'll leave it at that. So I'd like to talk to some of the things that make this book very influential and also rather controversial. And one of those things is the concept of grok, or grokking. And as we learn through the book, you know, Michael's using the word grok all the time, and the party around him, his water brothers, are starting to sort of come to terms with what grokking means as well, and what it means to grok. And we learn that it literally means to drink, but it has much more deeper meaning than that. It means to be one with, or to fully comprehend or immerse yourself into something, right? So it's got this very spiritual word almost as well in many ways for the Martians. And Michael, as he's starting to learn, you know, Earth culture and Earth religion, he starts to, he thinks he understands what God actually is. And he sort of, you know, comes to this epiphany and he says, yeah, I understand what God is. God is someone who groks, right? And that's one of the controversial aspects of the novel, because as his water brothers start to understand grokking and they start to become more Martian themselves, they start to learn the language, they start to refer themselves as God, like, you are God, you know. That's because they are someone who groks. So it's just one of those Western axiom, Western religion things that, you know, Robert Heinlein went out to challenge. And he does that very much so in this novel. So that was one of the very controversial things in the novel. So another thing that I found interesting in the novel, not necessarily controversial, is the biblical references in this novel. I mean, the book is just full of them. The title alone comes straight out of a Bible passage in Exodus in the Old Testament, right? Stranger in a Strange Land. And the book is full of references from Christian and I think also Muslim faith as well. So there's a lot of biblical references, which I found interesting. But I also like the way that Robert Heinlein did it. I don't think he was poking fun or deliberately going out to insult anyone, because I did read in one of the extracts when he was talking about this book, and he said something along the lines of, this is an invitation to think and not to believe. So I did enjoy the way he sort of addressed that subject, but I'd have to say that potentially the most controversial aspect, at least from a Christian worldview, was that, you know, that sense of grokking and you are God. But there are also other controversial aspects in the book. I mean, there's a whole lot of talk about free love and group sex and all these kind of things that happen in the novel. Again, I think Robert Heinlein was just out there to really challenge every status quo. So he really went out to challenge the man and male and female matrimony ceremony, right? And what does it mean to have like a water brother sort of communion where there's multiple people all married in union, right? So again, I think it was just one of those things where he wanted to challenge the concept of marriage between male and female, and he had this, you know, multitude of people doing these acts together, right? So there's a couple of very controversial things. There is another controversial thing, but I'm going to leave that for the things that I didn't like in this novel. So, like, the things that I like I said, I do like the concepts brought up in the book, and I did like the fact that he's trying to challenge the social norms, and he's basically unrestrained himself. He said, I'm going to go all out. I'm just going to throw it all out there and twist everything that I know is normal today, or, you know, social norm, and I'm going to break that rule and I'm going to see where this takes me, right? So I thought that was very interesting. Some very interesting concepts come up in the novel. I also did like the concept of, you know, really being alien, right? And what that means. And if you were brought up an alien, and the culture shock that comes from, you know, coming into something like the Western world, if you were, you know, from a place like Mars where it's completely alien, right? It's completely alien. So I did really enjoy that concept of, you know, what happens when something really alien comes into contact with humanity. And, you know, the obvious one is, you know, the challenge of, and the question asked, I really enjoyed as well, which is, you know, where do our morals come from? Where does morality have its base? And, you know, we can see that Michael Smith, although human, his morals are completely different to what we found in America during the novel was written, right? So it's a very, very interesting thought experiment. And I'd have to say, I also like this book better than any of the other books that we've had on the Sci-Fi Shed Ladder for Robert Heinlein. Maybe a bit of a spoiler for what might be coming up in the Shed Ladder, but let's leave that for the next little bit. Now, the things that I didn't like. Now, some people call this book dated, right? That hasn't dated well, and I'm particularly speaking to the treatment of women in this novel, but I'm going to say it hasn't dated. And before you hang up, listen to why I say that is, because I don't think it's dated, because I don't think behavior like that, especially talking about Jubal, I'm specifically talking about Jubal, I think behavior like that should never have been tolerated, irrespective of what time frame you come. I don't know, I don't remember my grandparents or my parents treating their wives the same way, or women in general, the way Jubal treated the women in this novel. So I just thought it was absolutely atrocious. And I don't think, I think it's a cop-out to say that this book is dated. Because I've read a lot of books from the 40s, 50s, 60s, and 70s. And I've got to say, yeah, there are aspects of things that date with time. And you see that a lot in things like E. Doc Smith's, where, you know, you have the damsel in distress and you have the hero who wants to come out and rescue this poor helpless woman. Yeah, I could call that dated, because they're not trying to down demean women, or, you know, put them down or treat them with little respect, right? They were trying to be the hero, you know, trying to help the lady, the damsel in distress. That I would call dated. This I'll call just unacceptable, irrespective of what century it's written in, right? Maybe you agree, maybe you completely disagree. That's my view on it. So that, I really did not like that aspect. I just thought Jubal's treatment of women was just terrible. And even the women themselves, the way they treated themselves was just like, they were just good for shopping and for looking good, really. It was just, and they were just constantly talked down to by Jubal. And sure, some would argue that, you know, Jubal, he did love these people. He treated them like his daughters and he brought them to the family unit. But mate, I just don't think it's acceptable. So let's leave it at that. I really didn't like it, if it's not obvious enough. When it comes to the memory test, I've got to say that this novel, Stranger in a Strange Land, I do enjoy it. And it has, for me, been more memorable than both Starship Troopers and The Moon is a Harsh Mistress. So when it comes to Robert Heinlein's, you know, Hugo and Nebula award-winning novels, I'd have to say that Stranger in a Strange Land, for me, was the most memorable of his novels, when at least the ones that were ranked on the Hugo and Nebula award system. It's time to rank it, so let's see where this book lands on our Sci-Fi Shed ladder. So back to the shit ladder, and ranking tonight's Hugo award-winning novel in Robert Heinlein's Stranger in a Strange Land. On the board, we've got on A side to B side, from ascending to descending order. And I think tonight we're going to start with Starship Troopers by Robert Heinlein, just as a good place to start on the A side. And I'm going to say that I enjoyed Stranger in a Strange Land a little bit more than I did Starship Troopers. I think the concepts, and some of the concepts in this novel, are just very strong, and they've made they've come into mainstream language, things like grok. The waterbed was first ever mentioned in Robert Heinlein's Stranger in a Strange Land. So the concept of the waterbed came out of this book, and it's also the only novel that I know that actually has a recognized religion come out of it. So there is a church, I think they're called the Church of the New World, something like that. Someone, I'm sure, will comment below. But it's the only novel that I know that actually inspired a new religion, right? So I'm going to say, as far as the characters, the influence in this novel, I enjoyed more than I did Starship Troopers. And I've got to say the same for The Moon is a Harsh Mistress. So I'm going to say that I did enjoy Stranger in a Strange Land more than I did The Moon is a Harsh Mistress. I did enjoy Robert Heinlein's The Moon, but it's not as memorable as A Stranger in a Strange Land was for me. So I'm going to say it's definitely better than The Moon is a Harsh Mistress. In some ways, The Fountains of Paradise is a great novel, and in some ways I enjoy Stranger in a Strange Land more, and it's more memorable in that sense. But there are areas in this novel that I really struggle through, and I've read both the abridged and the unabridged version, so and I don't find them too different as far as the concepts that I talked to in my dislike section. So I'm going to say no. The Fountains of Paradise, for me, I just enjoyed reading all the way through. It wasn't a challenge in any part of the book. Well, I did have some challenges and strengths, and I always do, but that's the strange thing. But I always reread this novel. It's a really good, really influential novel. So I don't want to take anything away from it. It is a very enjoyable read, a very good book, a very influential book that you do really owe it to yourself to read at least once. So I'm going to say it's better than The Moon, but it's going to go underneath Fountains of Paradise. So how do we stack them up? We had Stranger, and I wonder if you feel the same. We had Stranger in a Strange Land, for me, was the best of the Hugo award-winning novels from Robert Heinlein, followed by The Moon is a Harsh Mistress and Starship Troopers. So three of them, back-to-back, really, none in between. And I think they're all wonderful novels, controversial novels, interesting novels, very influential novels, highly recommended reads, or each and every one of them. That's how I'm going to rank them, and I've always pretty much been like that. There's nothing new for me. I've always enjoyed those novels in that order. I hope you enjoyed that. Where would you rank them? Do you agree, disagree with some of my comments and my thoughts? Where would you rank it? I know some people would put these books probably to top three, but not me. Hey, thank you for following along as always, and I hope to see you next time in the shed.